In this video, I'm going to show you how to create searchlight animations inside After Effects by using shape layers. Let's dive in. So I have an After Effects project open, and this is what we're going to be creating here today. So we have a city skyline with some searchlights in front of it, kind of animating back and forth, and these are created by using basic shape layers inside After Effects. So to get started, I'm going to go up to Composition, New Composition, and I'm going to name this Searchlights Animation. And then from the Presets menu, I'm going to choose my preset 1920 by 1080, 29 frames a second. And one of the key things is I change the duration to 10 seconds. That way, you know, it's going to be a relatively short animation, but you can extend it if you need to based on your own project needs. So next I'm going to grab my rectangle tool and just draw out a basic shape. It doesn't need to be anything fancy. We're going to change the size of it and the actual shape of it later. So one of the first things that we have to do here is make sure that we have linear gradient selected. What you can do in the top section where you can, you know, change the fill type, you can hold down option and cycle through the different options up there. Or you can click on the fill text button and then just be sure that linear gradient is selected. And then for stroke, just be sure that that's checked off. We don't want to add a stroke to it. And then next, what we have to do is change the color. So just be sure that both of the colors are white. And then for opacity, we have to change one of them to 0 and then the other one to 100. That way it fades in basically from one side being 0 opaque to 100 opaque. So next, what we have to do is twirl down gradient fill and change the alignment of the actual fill. So we'll change the X value for the endpoint to 0. So first change the start point's Y value, you know, experiment with it maybe to about 500 or so, and then change the endpoint value up so you have this nice gradient of it starting, you know, fully opaque at the bottom and then nothing at the very top. So next what we have to do is change this to a Bezier path. What you can do is right click where it says rectangle path and then change it to Bezier path. What this allows us to do is, you know, for example, click and drag one of these points to a custom area. So it's not necessarily a rectangle anymore. We can really, you know, shape this to however we want it. So what I'm going to do here specifically is be sure that path is selected and then hold down shift and click and drag both of these points to the top left section. And then what you'll notice is that we can keyframe this path. So I'm going to click on the stopwatch, go out to about 5 seconds or so, and then click back on the path, make a keyframe, and then just be sure that the path is selected, hold down shift, and then select both points at the top and slide it to the right. And then go to the very end and then click on the first keyframe, hit Command C and Control V to paste it to the end. So now if we play this back, we have a nice linear animation, but we can spruce this up a little bit by adding some Easy Ease. So just right click on the first keyframe, click on Easy Ease out, click on the middle keyframe and add Easy Ease. And then click on the last free keyframe, right click on it, and change it to Easy Ease In. This will ease into the animation, ease out of the keyframe. That's kind of Easy Ease. And then inside the graph editor, we can fine tune this animation a little bit more. We can click and hold down shift and drag on these handlebars to really fine tune how fast the animation happens between these keyframes. So as you can see in the middle, it's going to be a lot faster of an animation, and around the keyframes it is a lot slower as it eases in and out of those keyframes. And one last thing that you can do here is add a blur to it. So what you can do is go up to Effect, Blur and Sharpen and add Fast Box Blur. You can change it to maybe around 10 or so. This will just make it a little less hard on the edges. This will just make the edges a little bit softer. I'm going to knock it down to 8. You know, it doesn't need to be that much, just a little bit to soften the edges. And lastly, what we're going to do is duplicate it so we can do the other side of it. What you want to do is go to the beginning of the timeline, slide over the first keyframe, and actually click and drag the center keyframe to the beginning. And if you hold down shift, this will snap the keyframe to the playhead. And then move the first keyframe to the middle keyframe position. And then for the end, just click on the first keyframe, copy it by hitting Command C, and then Control V to paste it. Then you'll have to go back into the graph editor and fine tune the animation of this graph animation. So just, you know, click and drag the handlebars to get it kind of looking how the first animation looked for the first light. And lastly, what we can do here is just add in our city. I just downloaded this pick from freepik.com. A lot of great free graphic resources that you can use on that website. What I'm going to do to colorize it is make a new solid and just make it a blue color. I'm going to click OK and then change the blending mode from normal to color. That'll just pass through the color values. And next, what I'm going to do just to dim it down a little bit is add another solid, a black solid, and then make the opacity around like 55 or so. You know, that way it's there, but it's not there. It just makes it a little bit darker. And then to cap it off, I'm going to add an adjustment layer. And then in effects and presets, I'm going to type in vignette. And this will just add a nice vignette around the edges, kind of making it a little bit darker and a little bit more cinematic. And one last thing you can do is just knock down the opacity of the searchlights. So you can, you know, change it to around 65 or so. That way they're not as bright, you know. And this is the final product. We have a finished scene here for our searchlights. Hope you enjoyed this video tutorial. If you want to learn more about After Effects, there's several tutorials on my channel. Feel free to subscribe. And here's one that you might like right up there. But otherwise, I hope this tutorial has helped you. Leave comments down below, smash the like button, and we'll see you next time. Thanks for watching.